God's the tailor, and you're tailor-made. Today, I want to tell you that you are tailor-made. I know you're probably wondering, what does she mean, tailor-made? Well, a tailor does three things. When you take a suit in or a piece of fabric or clothes in, a tailor will either make you an outfit, a tailor will repair an outfit for you or change up a type of fabric for you, or a tailor will alter your outfit or alter the fabric that you give them. That is what a tailor does. So today I'm telling you that you were tailor-made because God is the ultimate tailor. God has made us. And he says in his word that we are fearfully and wonderfully made. So you should never doubt that you were made any less than what God has made you. And you are wonderfully made. You are marvelous. God has made you. So that's the first part. God is also your tailor because he has repaired you. It says in Ephesians 2:10 that we are his masterpiece. Because of Jesus Christ, we are made anew in him and able to carry out the plan for him. So understand that God has repaired you from your brokenness, from your doubt, from your worry, from your hurt. So you no longer have to walk in that brokenness because God has repaired you. And number three, he is the tailor because he is constantly altering you and making alterations to you. He's constantly taking things out of you that don't need to be inside of you. He's constantly removing people away from you that don't need to be in your life. See, every single thing that God has for you, he's making the alterations on you so that it will be able to fit just right with you when it comes into your life. So you have to understand today that you are tailor-made. And see, when a tailor are doing the alterations, what they will do is they'll have you stand there while they're doing the measurements and they're picking the needle and they're putting it in the areas that they're going to have to go back and work on. Well, basically, that's what God is doing. And what I want to tell you today is, since you are tailor-made, to understand that all you have to do is stand there and let God custom fit you and let God custom make you and let God make the alterations. Because see, if you move too much, that tailor's going to accidentally prick you. So stop moving. Stop trying to put your hand in certain situations that God is trying to custom make for you. So if you're looking for a spouse, I want you to every day say, God is the tailor, and God, I thank you because you are making that custom husband for me, or that custom wife for me, that I know you're making the alterations on so we can stand before the altar. If you're looking for a blessing, I want you to thank God as your tailor and say, thank you for giving me that financial blessing, or that spiritual blessing, or that physical blessing, that you are making the alterations to custom fit for my life and custom fit me. I also think if you're looking for a healing, you could just look into your tailor and say, God, I thank you for the alterations that you're making because you are custom fitting me to my healing and my change and the things that you're doing in my life. So you are tailor-made, and I want you to walk inside of that. I want you to understand that you are wonderfully and marvelously made by God, that he knows the number of hairs that are on your head, and that he has custom people for your life, a custom plan for your life, and he's continuously making the alterations so that every place you need to perfectly fit, you will fit in. Be blessed. I hope you enjoyed this message, and I will see you next week.